Hi, my name's Emily with the University of Maryland Extension, and today we're going to show you how to take a soil sample to get tested. I'm here at our new location at the Central Maryland Research and Education Center, and we're going to test the soil in these new garden beds. So you may be wondering why you need to test your soil. Well, a soil test is a great first step when you're starting a new garden or your lawn. It's going to tell you whether you have high, medium, or low nutrient levels for important elements like phosphorus, potassium, and magnesium that your plants will need to grow. Your soil test is also going to tell you the pH level. pH is the measure of acidity in your soil. So depending on what you're trying to grow is going to be dependent on what pH you need. It's going to be different for vegetables, lawn, or even a native plant bed. If you need to adjust that pH level to have the optimum pH, you can add lime or sulfur to raise or lower the soil pH. When can you test your soil? Anytime the ground is not frozen or it isn't too wet. There's a couple ways to test your soil. You can find these do-it-at-home kits at most garden centers or home improvement stores. They're about $20, but there's some pros and cons to this. It'll give you immediate results, but they may be a little difficult to read and perhaps aren't that accurate. The benefit of sending your soil into a testing lab is that it'll have an accurate reading and thorough measurements. It'll also give you some suggestions on how to amend the soil if you need to. Okay, so let's gather your supplies. You're going to need a submission form for sending in your soil sample. You can find these different labs to choose from on our website on the University of Maryland Extension. You can search for soil testing and make sure to choose the yard and garden page, not agriculture. We have multiple labs on there to choose from, and once you go to the laboratory website, you can find different forms to print off at home. You're also going to need something to dig the soil with. Oh, let me mention that soil tests should cost about anywhere from $11 to $30, depending on which one you choose. So to dig your soil, you're going to need a hand trowel will work, or a shovel, or even a sturdy spoon. You'll need something to send the soil in. So a zip top bag is a good resource, or you can even recycle an old coffee bag or bread bag that you have lying around. You'll need a bucket to mix your soil in and something to send it off in, an envelope or a box. Okay, so let's get digging. First, you want to remove any debris that's on the top. So any mulch, pull any mulch away, weeds, leaves, sticks, rocks. Then you want to go down about 4 to 6 inches. Take that sample, put it in your bucket, make sure there aren't any rocks, insects, anything in the soil, any roots that are still there. If it's turf, remove that turf. And you want to do this in multiple areas in your garden bed so you can have an accurate reading of the whole gardening area. Once you've taken samples from numerous spots, you want to mix that all around. Make sure it's not too wet. Throw out the rocks. And take about 1 to 2 cups of soil. Whatever soil lab you choose, they'll have specific instructions. You're going to put that in your bag. That's about 1 to 2 cups. Seal it up. Make sure you label it, especially if you're doing multiple areas. Say if you want to get the soil tested for your vegetable garden and your lawn, you want to make sure there's a label on there so the lab knows you're testing different areas. Put that in your box or your shipping envelope with your submission form and form of payment and send it off. So it's been about 3 weeks and we got our results in the mail. We also got it via email from this lab, and it's in that 3-week period, probably took that long because it's the spring and it's pretty busy. So if you can get your soil sample to the lab sometime in like late winter in preparation for the upcoming season, that probably won't take as long. We compared the results here that we got with our home kit test, and the pH level was about the same, but it was really difficult to read the nutrients on that, and those levels are off. So for about the same price, it's a good idea to use an accredited lab to get the results, and they'll also give you some recommendations with that. They sent some different flyers in the mail with us so we could read about the recommendations that they were giving. Some key things to look for on your report are the pH, the organic matter, and the different nutrient levels. So for pH, depending on what you're growing, you may need to raise or lower your acidity level, and you would use lime or sulfur for that. Your organic matter, anything above 2% is good. So as long as it's above that, you're in a good spot. And for the nutrient levels, anything that's showing excessive is really no big deal. You don't need to adjust those. Anything in the low area, you might want to adjust. For example, if you got your soil tested for your lawn area, you'll need to follow the Maryland fertilizer guidelines, and there are limits for phosphorus and nitrogen in particular. You can only add phosphorus if it's showing that it's low, so we can protect the Chesapeake Bay. And for the nitrogen, there's a limit for the year to put on. Another thing you want to look at and have tested is the lead in the soil if you're doing food gardening. Anything less than 400 parts per million is safe. If you need help interpreting your soil test report, you can send us a copy through Ask Extension and we can guide you on that, or you can bring a copy in to your local county extension or city extension office.